Today I'm going to risk the wrath of the paper gods by patterning 12 different variations of a basic flared skirt, all at once. Here, have a chart. The x-axis variations will determine how full the skirt is at the waist. You can make this curve to fit your waist exactly, which will result in a smooth, fitted skirt. Or you can make it much larger than your waist, and use gathers or pleats to reduce it. This will result in a much fuller skirt. For example, both this orange skirt and this plaid dress are technically half-circle skirts, but the plaid skirt has a larger waist that was pleated down, giving it a nice design detail in the pleats, but also making it much fuller at the hem. To simplify things, I'll make the curve on a fitted skirt match my waist measurement exactly, or 100%. For gathered skirts, you don't want them too terribly full or they'll get bulky. I think I'll make the gathered waist curve twice as large, or 200% of the finished waist measurement. And for pleated skirts, you can get away with a lot more fullness, because the pleats help keep it toned down up top. For pleated skirts, I'll triple the waist measurement, bringing it up to 300%. Of course, these aren't hard and fast rules. I literally just made them up, and you can do it however you want. You could make a lightly gathered skirt with 150% of your waist measurement, or you could make it 400%. You could pleat a 200% measurement and gather a 300% measurement. Everything will depend on what you want, what you find flattering, and what your design requires. But these are the baselines I'll be going with. Now for the y-axis variations, these are what percentage of a circle your pattern will use. The waist measurement determines how full the skirt will be at the waist, and the percentage of the circle determines how wide the skirt will be at the hem. I'm going to pattern 4 different variations. I will make full circle skirts, half circle skirts, quarter circle skirts, which are also called A-line skirts, and I'll make a 3/4 circle skirt, because sometimes you want a nice in-between option. To start, you only need 2 measurements, the waist and the length you want the skirt to be. My waist fluctuates between 27 and 28 inches, and after experimenting with making skirts anywhere from 26 to 30 inches at the waist, I found that my orange skirt with a waist measurement of 28.5 inches is my most comfortable skirt. For the length, I'm going to cut each pattern to 29 inches long. Allowing for seams and hems, this will give the skirts a finished length of 27 inches. I prefer nice wide hems, but if you're making a circle skirt or any kind of flared skirt, keep in mind that a narrow hem will stitch best, with the least amount of puckering, tucking, and twisting. So I would recommend allowing no wider than an inch for the hem. For our first pattern, let's start with the simplest, which is a full circle skirt with a fitted waist. Now I'm only going to be patterning a quarter of the skirt. So for my fitted skirt, this inner circle circumference needs to equal 28.5 inches, which means that for a quarter of the skirt, it needs to equal 1/4 of that, 7.125 or 7 1/8 of an inch. Actually, here's a conversion chart for fractions of an inch and decimals. I learned all of these by heart when I worked at fabric shops, but you might just want to screenshot them or copy them down. I'm going to go ahead and write that down at the top of the full column. Every full skirt pattern, no matter how wide the hem, will need to have a 7.125 inch measurement at this inner curve. Using this, we can go ahead and mark the other two columns. For the gathered skirts with a 200% waist measurement, we need to double that for a 14.25 inch curve. And the pleated skirts with a 300% waist measurement will need a 21.375 inch curve. Got it so far? Good. Now we need to take this 28.5 inch waist circumference and find the radius. I have found this to be the easiest and most reliable way to actually draft it on paper. You can use actual math for this with a classic middle school geometry formula, but this is the era of the internet, so you can also just look up a converter. I'll link the one that I used in the description box. So for this 28.5 inch circle, I have a 4.5 inch radius. So now we're ready to draft it out on paper. For a quarter of a circle, I need a 90 degree right angle. Starting from the angle, measure out 4.5 inches. Then you can measure that out at different points and connect the dots. Or if you have steady hands, you can use a string and swing out a nice curve. Then, before I forget, I'm going to draw a second line a half inch closer to the angle. This is where I'll cut out my pattern, and the first line will be my stitching line. But if you want to make a pattern without seam allowance, you can skip that part. Now I can measure down from the cutting line by 29 inches all across the outer curve. Connect those dots and this pattern is done and ready to cut out. I've built in seam and hem allowance at the top and bottom edge, but I left the sides without any allowance. I think this is the most convenient to use, but you could add seam allowance here if you prefer, but whichever you choose, you should definitely mark the pattern. Now check that back, measuring it, and you should come very close to 7 1/8 of an inch, or whatever your quarter waist measurement was. And congratulations! Pattern number 1 is done. The next two will also be simple. For the gathered and pleated full circle skirts, I just need to double and triple that waist measurement, giving us 57 inches and 85.5 inches, and then find those radius measurements, which are 9 and 13.625. Then they can be patterned along a 90 degree angle, just the same as the previous skirt. This is my gathered full circle skirt with a radius of 9 inches, giving me an inner curve of 14.25 inches. And here's what it looks like compared to my first pattern. For the pleated full circle skirt with a 300% waist circumference, I don't need to pattern it because I just did that when I made my Christmas dress last month. That project is what inspired this little pattern making endeavor. I usually just cut out my skirts from measurements, but in the name of efficiency, I realized that having just a good, versatile variety on hand would be worth the effort. This way I can see what they'll look like ahead of time and try different versions out on paper to see what fits my fabric best. Here is what those three patterns look like, and I am quickly running out of floor space. Now let's move on to our next variety. I'm going to come back to the three-quarter skirts later, so we'll work on the half-circle skirts. The big difference here is that a quarter of this skirt is actually going to be an eighth of a circle. So instead of this curve equaling 7.125 inches, actually half of that needs to measure 7.125, which means that this full theoretical inner circle needs to measure double 28.5 inches, making it 57 inches. So, finding the radius of 57 inches, we come to 9 inches. For the gathered skirt, we need to double 57, giving us 114, and for the pleated skirt, we need to triple it, giving us 171. The radii of those are 18.125 and 27.25. Now these three are ready to be patterned, but one thing is different. Instead of a quarter of a circle or a 90 degree angle, we are patterning only half of that, so an eighth of a circle or a 45 degree angle. I only have a tiny protractor, not really meant for these types of projects, so I find it easier just to take a right angle and fold that in half. But the method is exactly the same. Drawing a curve using one radius, marking the length, and cutting it out. Simple. And here are these three skirt patterns all laid out. So you can see that they are just as wide as the circle skirts at the top edges, but their sides flare out much less, like half. Now I'm going to repeat this entire process again, halving and doubling the measurements to make a quarter circle skirt, which is basically an A-line skirt, or a skirt that is almost straight but has a tiny bit of flare. I'm not sure if I would ever use the fitted version of this because I tend to prefer full skirts, but I definitely might use the pleated and gathered versions. These patterns are great for skirts that you want to gather, but you want to still be pretty slim. They give the look of gathers, but without the fullness up top that comes from gathering a completely straight skirt. I'll probably use one of these patterns when I make this dress, where it has light gathers, but you can see by the stripes that it also has some flare. So this time we'll only be patterning 1/16th of a full circle, and the curve of 1/16th must equal 7.125. So 7.125 multiplied by 16 gives us 114 inches for the fitted circumference, and 228, and 342 for the pleated and gathered circumferences. These all translate into radii of 18.125, 36.25, and 54.375. Am I losing you yet? To pattern them, you need a 22.5 degree angle, or you can take a right angle and fold it in half for an eighth, and then fold that in half to find 1/16th. Then they can be patterned in the usual manner. With the fitted version, it's slim enough to fit closely around the hips, so you might want to check it. Measure the distance between your waist and the fullest part of your hip, and mark that on your pattern. Now measure the fullest part of your hips. Divide that by 4, and compare it with the width of your pattern at the corresponding part. If you have a more hourglassy figure with a wider gap between your waist and hip measurements, this might be tight. In that case, you could just add a bit of slope to the pattern to ease it out over your hips. I did find that here the radii were so long that it would have been extremely impractical to try and pattern them the same as I did the others. So I took a shortcut by subtracting the radii from each other and measuring out each waistline on the same piece. So start at your first waist measurement and go down by 18.125 inches. I traced this onto fresh paper with a rolly wheel tool, which I have no earthly clue what they're actually called, but mine is sharp enough to make indentations on the paper below, which I could then go and trace with a pen. Then I could extend the lines down, and here is the 200% pattern. Repeat this one more time for the 300% pattern. Now there is one last variation I want to make, and that's a three-quarter circle skirt. Sometimes a full circle is just too much, or you don't have quite enough fabric, but a half circle just seems lackluster. So I thought a nice in-between option would be good to have on hand. To pattern a quarter of this skirt, you will be using 3/16ths of a circle, and you need that inner curve to equal 7.125 inches. So how we find the circumference of our theoretical full circle is by taking 7.125 and dividing it by 3 to find 1/16th, which for me was 2.375. Then that number can be multiplied by 16, which came out to exactly 38 inches. So just to recap, 38 inches is the circumference of the theoretical inner circle, of which we will only be using 3/4. You can verify your measurement by multiplying it by 0.75. If you end up with your waist measurement again, you did it right. So 38 inches can be doubled and tripled, giving us 76 inches and 114 inches. And these measurements can be converted, giving us radii of 6, 12, and 18.125. To pattern the skirts, we need an angle of 67.5 degrees. I'm actually just going to take my quarter circle and my half circle and add them together. And the rest of the patterning is the same from here. And here's what they all look like. Was that a lot? I feel like that was a lot. Does your brain hurt yet? Well, mine does too, but that's why I just wanted to get it all done so that I can have them, and for future projects I can just pick one and not have to worry about this math ever again. And now I feel like I need to go, like, burn a sacrifice to appease the gods of paper waste, except burning anything sounds wasteful. But I don't think it's a waste. These patterns will go to good use, and in the long term they probably will save me from a lot of future paper waste. I won't need to make individual skirt patterns for future projects, and I won't waste fabric by messing up my measurements. For the type of sewing I do, this set will make almost any skirt I need. Now, for you, you might not need 12 whole patterns, but I hope I've shown that no matter what kind of pattern you do want to make, the principles are the same. So if you'd like to see more of my work, you can subscribe to me here on YouTube and go follow my Instagram. For my next project, I'll be repatterning and remaking this old jumper dress, which has been like the number one request since I started making videos. And I also have a second channel if you enjoy world building or writing. See ya!